What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo from the BTNHD, and today is all about installing PDQ Deploy as well as deploying Office 2019. So let's get right into it. All right, so before we even start the installation guide and also showing you guys how to deploy Office 2019, let me let you guys know right now, I've never used this software before. I had a friend that contacted me and he was like, hey, Bernardo, can you help me out in creating a Office 2019 package with PDQ Deploy? I was like, I never used it before. Why can't you just do it with SCCM? He was like, my job can't afford SCCM. They're using PDQ Deploy. Can you help me out? I don't understand it. So I had to go home in my home lab and build a nice little machine using this software. And it's a pretty cool software. So this is how I got it set up. All right. So the first thing I needed to do is get the exe file, the PDQ Deploy. I think the latest version is 18.4.0.0. And just right click on it, run it as administrator. It starts preparing to install. I get the nice little setup, clicked on next, accept the license and terms, clicked on next. I left it as the default because, again, I don't know how to use it. So I just leave everything as the default as of now. And click next there, install. It's going to start installing and click on finish. It's going to start launching. And then you got a nice little initialize the PDQ Deploy. Click next here. For the license key, you have two. You have enterprise and then you have use free mode. So I say, look, I'm testing this out. Let's see how it works out. I'm going to do the free mode for now because I installed it within an Active Directory environment, because it looks like PDQ Deploy works great within the Active Directory environment. So enter your domain, enter username, and enter a password, and then click on finish. It's going to load up and then you're good to go. Once the installation part was done, I was happy. It looks like it was up and running with no issues. So it was time for me to create my Office 2019 package. So we need to grab our installation files. Now, as you know, Microsoft changed the way that we install Office. It's not double-click the exe file, give it some switches, some parameters, and you're done. It gets a little complicated, so I recommend that you download the Office deployment tool and then also head to the OCT site and build your XML file. Now, I'm not going to go over how to build an XML file. It is basically an answer sheet, and I'm going to show you a quick example of it. I did do a video on my YouTube channel, look for it, dealing with the breakdown of how to create it. But getting basically this and going here will create the XML file. I'm going to show you an example of it, so don't freak out. Now, within the folder where I dropped all my exe files, you're going to see a Pro Plus XML file. If you open it up, this is basically an example. This is not what I use behind the scenes because I got more stuff that I can't show you guys. But if you go to that site, which I'm going to provide the link at the bottom, you could go and create your own and you should be good to go. Okay, because you need that XML file. When you're creating your package, you need to have a command line. And the command line is the following: setup with the parameter of config, and you're calling out your XML file. Now, the XML file, I called it Pro Plus. You could call it whatever you want. It's up to you. It's time to actually create the package. And once you load up the console on the toolbar, there's a button that says New Package. Click on it. It loads up the package wizard or dialog box, and you're going to give it a name. I gave it Microsoft Office 2019, right? Pretty simple. And I went to Steps. And within Steps, I clicked on Install. Now, for the install file, I clicked on the three little dots to browse, and I located my setup.exe file, and I open it up. Excellent. The parameters, I enter the parameters of /configure and calling out that XML file. From my understanding, you have to check off include the entire drive, right? Because you have other files that you want to include within the package to deploy successfully. Once you're done with that, you want to go to Properties, go to Options, and make sure within Run As you have the correct user account that has access to deploy within the machines that you want within your network, okay? For me, I left it as deployed as user because the account that I'm logged into this machine has full access within my network, and that account is able to install programs with no problem. Now, once you're done with that, click on that big button that says Save, It saves it, you close it, and there goes our package. Now, once your package is done, it is time for us to deploy it to your machines. Now, again, this is my first time using PDQ, so I thought I needed a client to install to all my machines to push out the package, but that wasn't the case. So I actually used one of my machines, which is called vtest.btnhd.edu, which is part of my domain. As you can see, within programs and features, I don't have Microsoft Office installed at all. Let's go back inside the console. And on the right side of the console, there's a big button that says deploy. If you click on it, you got two options. You can either pick deploy once or schedule your deployment. So I clicked on deploy once. You get this nice little wizard. I typed in my full qualified domain name of that computer. I clicked on add computer. It started scanning and it found it. Got a green check mark. That is a good thing. Then from here, just hit deploy. Once you hit deploy, you're going to see within the deploy section of this little panel right here, it's going to start saying running. At the very bottom where it says target, it's queued up. Eventually, the status is going to change to connecting. And once it changes, it's going to start copying the package over to the machine that you're deploying this, you know, software into, right? Once the copying is completed, the status is going to change to run. And then eventually within programs and features, you're going to see Office 2019, you know, installed. I was like, whoa, that's pretty cool. I didn't need to install any client. Automatically, PDQ just pushed out the software with no problem. So eventually when you go back to your testing machine, you're going to see within programs and features your Office 2019, which is cool. Now, one thing that I found out that within PDQ, the status is still going to state running. So let the status change to successful, and then you're able to go back into your testing machine. It's there. Click on start. All your programs are there, and you're able to click on one of the programs to launch up, which I clicked on Word. It launches up, and that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that thumbs up. Do not forget about punch, elbow, and smashing that subscribe button to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.